Dr. Maz, E. Monroe puts it like this. He says that when we speak of death, he said the greatest tragedy in life is not death, but the greatest tragedy in life is for us to live a life without purpose. I took a time out today to address our young people when we speak of living our lives with purpose and finding that thing that God has called us to do in the earth. I believe that every human being on planet Earth was created to be a part of a resolution mechanism. When this is realized, the true leader in you emerges and your significance is born. When we speak of our gang activities, we're watching the news, we're seeing the deaths, the bloodsheds, young men going to prison, young men being carried over in body bags. And most of the times, those persons who are in gang activities are those persons who do not know their purpose, who do not recognize that there's so much more that God has for them rather than being a part or to have an identity, being a part of a gang. When we speak of that, I've worked 17 years within the Ministry of Education, program sure, 6-7 years. Sister Mary, working over at Tabernacle Baptist Christian Academy as a guidance counselor, ears on the ground, hearing a lot of cries of the young people. Most of us live on the surface, and because we live on the surface, we act spontaneously. We just respond. But persons who live from their being, the core of their being, their decisions are so much better than those persons who just live on the surface. God doesn't want you to live on the surface. He wants you to live from the core of yourself, your true self, your spirit being. That's what he wants you to live. Let's look at the outcome of the gang activities. Let's look at the hazards that it caused. Two things is going to happen. Prison, right? Prison, which is a form of death. And in some sense, if you were to look at it, you go to prison, you die. The outcome is not a good outcome. God had said before us, he said, I said before you today, life and death. There's an open door. He wants you to choose life. This is what he wants you. I'm guaranteeing you that the gang activities that you are involved in as a young man, as a young woman, think a little deeper. Let's look at the hazards. You're losing your freedom on a regular basis. You may not go to prison, but you're losing your freedom. I can turn my door, go anywhere that I want to go, take my wife and my son anywhere that we want to go without fear. I'm not a menace to society. I haven't done anything. I'm not even thinking along those lines. But for you, who is a part of that gang, you've lost your freedom. When you were to go anywhere, you got 5-6 guys behind you. Why? For protection. There's a fear that you walk with. You know what the outcome is. The outcome is either you go to jail, you kill someone, or someone kills you. I'm telling you that that's not God's plans for your life. God has a greater calling for you. And it's time now for you to look deep within yourself and make better decisions. I'm offering my number, 805-1801. Share this message to as much person as possible. We want to be here to help you, to guide you, to those persons who have been misinformed or misdirected so that you would be redirected into your purpose. God has a greater calling for your life, and it's time that you begin to make better decisions and think about realistically about your future. What do you want? Where do you want to live? How much income do you want to make? We got to begin to think about ourselves. And when you find purpose, you begin to think about these things, those questions. And you know what? You begin to breathe. Your life begins to take form. Your life begins to develop. That's the life of purpose that God has for you. But if you stay in that activity, the outcome is not good. The outcome is not good. So today, the choice, it is your choice. Choose life. This is what God is saying today.